Hello everyone, myself Bismi Bicharyan, assistant professor at Suresh Gandhi High University. Today we are going to discuss about the HTML, XML, CSS and the programming languages. So learning objectives, this lesson will help the students understand HTML, XML, CSS and the programming languages. What are the outcomes after this lesson? Students will be able to describe HTML, XML, CSS, and programming languages. So first, we'll see the HTML. What is HTML? So HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. The full form of the HTML is Hypertext Markup Language. And it is used to design web pages using markup languages. Okay, so the HTML is used to design web pages using markup language. The HTML is the combination of hypertext and markup language. So the HTML is the combination of hypertext and markup language. So the HTML stands for the hypertext markup language and it is used to design web pages using markup language. The HTML is the combination of hypertext and the markup language. Okay, this is the combination of hypertext and the markup language. Hypertext defines the link between the web pages. Okay, this defines the link between the web pages. Markup language is used to define the text document within the tag, which defines the structure of the web page. So the HTML is the combination of hypertext and the markup language. So hypertext defines the link between the web pages. In the web page, there are links. So the hypertext define the link in between the web pages, where the markup language that define the document, text document within the tag, which define the structure of the web page. This language is used to annotate text so that a machine can understand it and manipulate text accordingly. Most of markup language are human readable. Okay, so most of the HTML language or markup languages are human readable. And this language is used to make notes for the computer. Okay, so the computer can easily understand the language. And most of the markup and HTML language are the human readable. Languages uses tags to define what manipulation has to be done on the text. So this is the HTML. The HTML is a markup language which is used by the browser to manipulate text, images, and other content to display if it in the required format. So the HTML is a markup language that is used by the browser. Okay, this is used by the browser to manipulate text, images, and other content to display it in required format. HTML was created by Tim Berners-Lee in 1991. The first ever version of the HTML was HTML 1.0, but the first standard version was HTML 2.0. which was published in 1999. HTML is the standard markup language for creating web pages. So this is the HTML is the standard markup language for creating the web page. And this is created by the Tim Berners-Lee in 1991. And the first version of the HTML was HTML 1.0 and the first standard version was HTML 2.0 and that standard version of the HTML was published in 1999 after the creation of the basic HTML. Okay, the in 1999 the standard version has been created. And this HTML is the standard markup language for creating the web pages. Elements and tags in the HTML. So HTML uses predefined tags and elements. Okay, though HTML uses predefined tags and the elements, which tells the browser about content display property. Okay, the predefined tags that tells to the browser what content display property. If a tag is not closed, then browser applies that effect till end of the page. Okay, so elements and the tags, these are the, these are the tag element and this is opening tag and this is closing tag. Okay, and this is the tag element. So elements and tag in this HTML that are predefined tags. Okay, predefined, there are predefined tags and the elements that tells to the browser about content display property. If a tag is not closed, then browser applies that effect till end of the page. HTML page structure. The basic structure of the HTML page is given below. It contains, so this is the basic structure, okay. So it contains some elements like head, title, body, etc. These elements are used to build the blocks of the web pages. Doc type HTML. Okay, this is opening tag and this is closing tag. And this tag is used to tell the HTML version. Okay, which type of the HTML is we are using in that. So this is the this is used to tell which type of the HTML we are using. This current tells that the version is HTML5. Okay, so this currently tells that the we are using the HTML5. Then this is HTML. This called HTML root element and used to wrap all the code. Okay, this opening tag and closing tag, in between that there is HTML. So this is called as HTML root element. Okay, this is called as HTML root element and this is used to wrap all the codes. Then next is head. Okay, head tag contain metadata, title, page CSS, etc. So in this head tag, we are using the metadata, title, pages, page CSS, etc. All the HTML elements that can be used inside the head elements. Okay, all the HTML elements that we are using inside the head element, like opening tag, style and closing tag, opening tag, title and closing tag, opening tag, title, base and closing. So these all are the tags. In the body tag is used to enclose all the data which a web page has from text to link. Okay, the body tag is used to enclose all the data which a web page has from text to link. All the content that you see rendered in the browser is contained within the element. So this is the HTML page structure. So these all are about the HTML. Let's see the features of the HTML. It is easy to learn and easy to use. Okay, the HTML is easy to learn and easy to use. It is platform independent. Okay, the HTML is platform independent. Images, video, and audio can be added to the web page. Okay, in this HTML web page, images, video, audio can be added. Hypertext can be added to the text. Hypertext can be added to the text and it is a markup language. So the features of the HTML is it is easy to learn and easy to use. Its platform is independent. Images, videos and audios can be added to the web page. Hypertext can be added to the text and it is a markup language. So why we should learn the HTML? So it is a simple markup language, okay. The HTML is a simple markup language. Its implementation is easy. Okay, it's a simple markup language. Its implementation is easy. And it is used to create a website. Okay, this HTML is used to create a website. And it also helps in developing fundamentals about web programming. Okay, so the HTML helps in developing fundamentals about web programming. And it boosts professional career. Okay, this HTML boosts the professional career. So these are the things, the answer of why we should learn the HTML. So let's see the advantages of the HTML. The HTML is used to build a website. Okay, this is used to build a website and it is supported by all the browsers. Okay, the HTML is supported by all the browsers. And it can be integrated with other languages like CSS, JavaScript. Okay, the HTML can be integrated with other languages like CSS and JavaScript. There are some disadvantages of the HTML. HTML can create only static web pages. Okay, the HTML can create only static web pages. So for dynamic web page, other languages have to be used. HTML can create only static web pages. So for dynamic web pages, other languages has to be used. Large amount of the code has to be written to create a simple web page. So this is the one disadvantage of the HTML. Large amount of the code we have to write to create a simple web page. Then security feature is also not good in the HTML. So these are the disadvantages. So the main disadvantages is there are lots of code we have to write when we are creating this HTML page, and the security feature is also not good. HTML can create only static web pages. Okay, static. So for dynamic web page, we have to use other languages. Okay, so these all are the disadvantages of the HTML. And let's see once again the advantages of the, what are the advantages of the HTML? HTML is used to build a website. Okay, it is used to build a website. It is easy to use also. Okay, and it is supported by all the browsers. Then the HTML is supported by all the browsers, and it can be integrated with other languages like CSS, JavaScript. So these are the basic information about the HTML. Okay. Next is XML. So XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. Okay. XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. XML is a markup language much like HTML. Okay, this is the markup language, same like the, almost same like the HTML. XML was designed to store and transport data. Okay, this XML was designed to store and transport the data. XML was designed to be self-descriptive. Okay, this XML was designed to be self-descriptive. XML is a W3C World Wide Web Consortium recommendation. Okay, so XML stands for the Extensible Markup Language. XML is a markup language almost same like the HTML. XML was designed to store and transport data. XML was designed to be self-descriptive. And this is a W3C, the full form of the W3C is a World Wide Web Consortium recommendation. Okay. So this was the XML. Let's see the difference between the XML and the HTML. So HTML, so the full form, the first difference is the full form. The HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language, where the XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. Okay, the full form between the HTML and XML is the main difference. Okay, HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language, XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. Then a standard markup language for creating web pages and the web applications. Okay, HTML we are using for creating a web pages and the application. Whereas the XML, a markup language that define a set of rules for encoding documents in a format that is both human and machine readable. Okay, so this is the HTML is the markup language that is we are using to create the web pages and the web applications, whereas the XML is the markup language that define a set of rules for encoding documents. Okay, that define a set of rules for the encoding documents in a format that both machine and human can read. Okay, next difference is this HTML is case insensitive. Okay, whereas the XML is case sensitive. Okay, the next, HTML has predefined tags. Okay, HTML has predefined tags, but XML has programmer defines his own set of the tag. Okay, in this XML, the programmer defines the tag, but in the HTML, there is already predefined tags are there in the HTML, whereas the XML, in this XML, the programmer defines that set of the tags. The HTML, some tags do not have a closing tag in the HTML. Okay, in the HTML, some tags don't have a closing tag, but in XML, that is mandatory to close each tag. Okay, in the XML, it is mandatory to close each tag that has been used. But in the HTML, some tags do not have a closing tag. The HTML focuses on the displaying data. Okay, the HTML focuses on the displaying data, whereas the XML focuses on the carrying information. Okay, this is the responsible for the how our page looks. Okay, looks like, but the XML focuses on how to carry the information. Okay, carrying information. So this is the main again difference. Next, the HTML helps to develop the structure of the web page. Okay, HTML helps to develop the structure of the web page, whereas the XML helps to exchange data between the different platforms. Because the XML carry the information, that helps to exchange the data between the platform, but the HTML is only responsible for the structure of the web pages. So these are the difference between the HTML and the XML. HTML we are using for only to create the web pages, whereas the XML we are using to carry the information. Okay, and the full form itself is a main difference. XML stands for the extensible markup language, whereas the HTML stands for the hypertext markup language. So these all are the difference between the HTML and the XML. Next is the difference between XML and HTML. XML and HTML were designed with different goals. XML was designed to carry data with focus on what data is, whereas the HTML was designed to display data with focus on how data looks. Okay, the look of the page is HTML, but the content of the page is XML. XML tags are not predefined, but the HTML tags are predefined. XML does not use predefined tags. Okay, so the programmer decides which tag he has to use. The XML language has no predefined language. The tag in the example above, like, to, from, are not defined in anything XML standard. These tags are invented by the author of the XML document. Whereas the HTML works with predefined tag. This is the opening tag and the closing tag. Okay, with XML, the author must define both the tags and the document structure. Then next is XML is extensible. Most XML application will works as expected, even if new data is added. Okay, imagine an application designed to display the original version of Node XML. Okay, so these are the tags. Imagine a newer version of node.xml with added date, hour, elements, and removed heading. Okay, in this tag, to, from, heading, body, these all are the tags. But in the new version of the node.xml is, we have added date, hour, elements, and we have removed the heading tag from here. So this is extensible. Next, the XML simplifies the things. Okay, it simplifies data sharing, it simplifies data transport, platform changes, and data availability. Okay, the XML simplifies data sharing, data transport, platform changes, and data availability. So these all are about the XML. Next is CSS. So CSS is cascading style sheet. Okay, cascading style sheet, fondly referred to as CSS. CSS, cascading style sheet. This is a simply designed language intended to simplify the process of making web pages presentable. Okay, this is the simply designed language that is used to make the web pages presentably. CSS allows you to apply styles to the web page. Okay, the CSS allows you to apply styles to the web pages. More importantly, CSS enables you to do this independent of the HTML that makes up each web page. Okay, the CSS enables you to do that independently. Okay, the HTML that makes up each web page. So we are using the CSS to make our web page presentable. Okay, and this is this CSS allows you to apply styles to the web pages. So cascading style sheet is this allows to add the styles to the web pages. CSS is easy to learn and understood. but it provides powerful control over the presentation of an HTML document. Okay, this CSS is easy to learn and understandable, can be easily understandable, but it provides a powerful control over the presentation of an HTML document. CSS saves our time. You can write CSS once and reuse same sheet in the multiple HTML page. Okay, this CSS saves our time because if we have written any CSS once, and that CSS we can reuse the same sheet in the multiple HTML web page. So this is the way it saves our time. Sorry. It is easy maintainable. Okay, easy maintenance. To make a global change, simply change the style and all the elements in all the web pages will be updated automatically. Okay, easy to maintain. Because when we are simply changing any style, okay, we are saying global change, okay, if we are changing any styles, okay, our elements in that automatically updated in all the web pages. So this is easy to maintain and it saves our time, okay, and easy to learn. Search engine about the CSS. Search engine CSS is considered as clean coding techniques, which means search engine won't have to struggle to read its content. Okay, so the CSS is easy, is considered as clean coding technique, which means search engine won't have struggle to read its content. Okay, so search engine find out it very easily. Okay, CSS web page find out by the search engine very easily, because this content of the CSS is very clean. Okay, they have very clean coding technique. Okay, so the search engine won't have to struggle to read its content. Then superior style to the HTML. Okay, superior styles to the HTML. CSS has a much wider array of attributes than HTML. Okay, CSS has a much wider array of attributes than HTML. So you can give a far better look to your HTML page in comparison to the HTML attribute. Okay, CSS has a much wider array of attributes than the HTML. You already know that. And it gives a far better look to your HTML page in comparison to the HTML attribute. Next is offline browsing. CSS can store web applications locally with the help of offline cache using of this we can view offline websites. So CSS can store web applications locally with the help of offline cache. Okay, and we can use in offline website. Sorry. The declaration block contains one or more declarations separated by semicolons. Okay, the declaration block in the CSS that contain one or more declarations separated by the semicolons. Each declaration includes a CSS property, name, value, and that is separated by a colon. Okay. So the each declaration includes a CSS property name and a value separated by a colon. For example, sorry, color. Color is property, but blue is the value. Okay, color is the property, but blue is the value. Font size is the property. 12 pixel is the value. Okay, font size is the property. But 12px is the value. A CSS declaration always ends with a semicolon. Okay, the CSS declaration that always ends with the semicolon. The declaration blocks are surrounded by curly braces. Okay, the declaration blocks are surrounded by curly braces. So this is the example of that P. Okay, and this is curly braces. Okay, in this curly braces, the property is color. Value is red. Okay, and the property is font. Okay, font size and the value is 24 pixels. So this is the CSS tags. Okay, so that CSS declaration always end with the semicolon. Okay, look at here. This is ended with the semicolon. Here this is ended with the semicolon because the property we have written here and the value also we have written here, and that is ended with the semicolon. So this is the CSS declaration. The CSS specifications are maintained by the World Wide Web Consortium. Same likewise XML. W3C, the full form of W3C is World Wide Web Consortium. The XML is also maintained by the World Wide Web Consortium. Okay. And internet media type, MIME type, text CSS is registered for use with CSS by RFC, remote function call. The full form of RFC is remote function call. The W3C operates a free CSS validation service for the CSS documents. The World Wide Web Consortium operates a free CSS validation. Okay. The W3C operates a free CSS validation service. CSS validation service for the CSS documents. So these all are about the CSS. Okay. So we have seen the HTML web page, XML, and the CSS. So these all are about the introduction about the CSS, HTML, and the XML. Let's see the programming languages. Okay. So programming language is set of rules that provide a way of telling a computer what operation to perform. Okay. The programming, what is programming language? The programming language is a set of rules that provides a way of telling a computer what operation to perform. A program language is a set of rules for communicating an algorithm. Okay, a programming language is a set of rules for communicating an algorithm. It provides a linguistic framework for describing computations. Okay, this programming language provides a linguistic framework for the describing computation. Programming language is a notational system. Programming language is a notational system for describing computation in a machine readable and the human readable form. So the programming language is a notational system for describing computation in a machine readable as well as a human readable form. So programming language is a set of rules that provide a way of telling a computer what operation to perform. Sorry. A programming language is a tool for developing executable models for a class of problem domain. Okay, the programming language is a tool for developing executable models for a class of problem domain. English is a natural language. It has words, symbols, grammatical rules. Okay, so we are talking about the English language. So English language is a natural language. It has words, symbols, and grammatical rules. A programming language also has words, symbols, rules of the grammar, same likewise the English. Okay, so the English and the programming language both have the words, symbols, rule of the grammars. The grammatical rules are called as syntax. Okay, in the programming language, the grammatical rule is called as syntax. Each programming language has a different set of syntax rule. Okay. Each programming language has a different set of syntax rules. So the programming language has the word, symbol, and the rules of the grammar. The rules of the grammar is called as syntax, and each programming language has different set of syntax rule. Programming languages have evolved over time as better way have been developed to design them. First programming languages were developed in 1950s. Okay. Sorry. First programming languages were developed in 1950s. Since then, thousands of the languages have been developed. Okay. After that, thousands of languages have been developed. Different programming languages are designed for different types of the program. So different programming languages are designed for the different type of the programs. So generation of the programming language, first generation languages are there, second generation language, third generation language, fourth generation language, and fifth generation languages are there. In the first generation language, that is machine language. Okay, the first generation language is machine language. In this, operation codes such as addition and subtraction Okay, in that language only the that contain the operational code such as addition and subtraction. Then in that machine language there is operands. There are operands also present. The operands that identify the data to be processed. The machine language is the machine dependent, as it is the only language the computer can understand. Okay, human being can't understand this machine language. Only the computer can understand this language. So first generation language is the machine language, and it is very efficient. It has very efficient code, but very difficult to write. So machine language, that is first generation language, that contain operation code such as addition and subtraction, and it also contain the operands. Okay, the operands that identify the data to be processed. And machine language is machine dependent, as it is the only language that computer can understand, and it is very efficient. It has very efficient code, but it is very difficult to write. So this is all about the first generation language. Let's see the second generation language. This is also called as assembly language, and this is symbolic operation code that is replaced by binary operation code. Okay, so this is the symbolic operation code that replaced binary operation code. Assembly language program needed to be assembled for execution by the computer. So the assembly language program needed to be assembled for execution by the computer. Each assembly language instruction is translated into one machine language instruction. Okay. Each assembly language instruction is translated into one machine language instruction. And it is very efficient code and very easy to write. So this is all about the assembly language. This is very efficient code and very easy to write. And assembly language program needed to be assembled for execution by the computer. And each assembly language instruction is translated into one machine language instruction. So this is all about the assembly language. Next is third generation language. This is closer to the English language. Okay, the third generation language is closer to the English language, but included simple mathematical notation. Okay, this third generation language is closer to the English language, but included simple mathematical notation. The programs written in the source code, which must be translated into machine language programs, that is called as object code. Translated into machine language program that is called as object code. The translation of the source code to object code is accomplished by a machine language system program called a compiler. Okay, the translation of source code to object code is accomplished by a machine language system program called compiler. Alternative to compilation is interpretation, which is accomplished by a system program called interpreter. Okay, alternative to compilation is interpretation, which is accomplished by a system program called the interpreter. Common third generation languages examples are Fortran, COBOL, C and C++, and Visual Basic. So these all are about the third generation language. Next is fourth generation languages. This is a high level language that requires fewer instruction to accomplish a task than a third generation language. Okay, so this is a high level language that requires fewer instruction to accomplish a task than a third generation language. And this is used with databases, query languages, report generators, form designers, and application generators. So this is all about the fourth generation language. It has high level language that requires fewer instruction to accomplish a task than a third generation language. It is used with the database, query languages. It contains query languages, report generators, form designers, and the application generators. Next is fifth generation language. This is also called as declarative language, and it is also called as non-procedural or very high level. Okay, program that specify what to be done rather how to do it. Okay, so the declarative language is non-procedural or very high level language. In this, the program specify what to be done rather than how to do. Then functional. List the second oldest high level programming language in widespread use today. Scheme. So these are the example. Lisp, second oldest. Scheme, SML, and this is also called as applicative. Everything is a function. Then logic, prologue, based on the mathematical logic rule. Okay, this is based on the mathematical logic rule. Beyond the fifth generation language, though no clear definition at present. Okay, beyond the fifth generation language, though no clear definition at present, natural language program generally can be interpreted and executed by the computer with no other action by the user than stating their questions. Limited capability at present. So though beyond the fifth generation, though no clear definition at present, natural language program generally can be interpreted and executed by the computer with no other action by the user than the stating their questions. Then PL, programming language have two broad groups. First is traditional programming language and second is object-oriented language. So in traditional programming language, there are sequence of the instruction. Okay, in traditional programming language, there are sequence of the instruction. First, second and some third generation language coming under in the traditional programming language. So in this traditional programming language, there are sequence of the instruction. In this first, second and third generation languages are coming under in this traditional programming language. Next is object-oriented language. Okay, the object-oriented language, objects are created rather than the sequence of the instruction. Okay, in this object-oriented language, the objects are created rather than the sequence of the instruction. Some third generation and the fourth and fifth generation coming under in this object-oriented language. So in this object-oriented languages, objects are created rather than the sequence of the instruction. In this some third generation, fourth and fifth generation coming under in this object-oriented language. So PL have two broad groups, that is traditional programming language and the object-oriented language. In traditional programming language, there are sequence of the instruction, and in object-oriented language, there are objects are created rather than the sequence of the instruction. Okay, in this traditional programming language, some first, second, and some third generations are coming under in this traditional programming language, while in object-oriented language, some other objects are created rather than the sequence. Some third generation and fourth and fifth generation coming under in this object-oriented language. Next is basic. So beginner's all-purpose symbolic instruction code. In this basic is beginner's all-purpose symbolic instruction code. The full form of the basic is beginner's all-purpose symbolic instruction code. And it was developed at Dartmouth College in mid of 1960s. Okay, this basic programming language was developed at the Dartmouth College in mid of 1960s. And it was developed as a simple language for the students to write programs with which they could interact through terminals. Okay, so the basic programming language was developed as a simple language for students to write programs with which they could interact through the terminals. So the basic, the full form of the basic is beginner's all-purpose symbolic instruction code. Next is C programming language. C programming language was developed by Bell Laboratory in the early 1970s. Okay, the C language was developed by Bell Laboratories in the 1970s. It provides control and the efficiency of the assembly language while having third generation language features. This C language provide control and the efficiency of the assembly language while having third generation language features. Often it is used for system program. The C language is used for the system program. Unix is written in the C. Language. So object-oriented programming language. Simula. Okay, Simula is the example of the object-oriented programming language. It is first object-oriented language. Okay, this Simula is first object-oriented language. it is developed by Ole Johan Dahl in 1960. it was developed by Ole Johan Dahl in the 1960s, and first purely object-oriented language, symbolized first purely object-oriented language, and still in use on some computer. Okay, still also this is used in some computers, similar object-oriented programming language. Then next is C++. So C++ is a C language with additional features. Okay, C++ is a C language with additional features. It is widely used for developing systems and the application software. C++ we are using for the developing system and the application software. Graphical user interfaces can be developed easily with visual programming tools. Okay, the graphical users interfaces can be developed easily with the visual programming tools. Next is Java. An object-oriented language similar to the C++ that eliminates lots of C++ problematic features. Okay, the Java is also again object-oriented language similar to the C++. C++ has some problematic features. In this Java, they all the problematic features are eliminated from the CSS. Okay, so the Java is created. So an object-oriented language that is similar to the C++ that eliminate all the lots of the C++ problematic features, and it allows a web page developer to create programs for the applications. Okay, it allows a web page developer to create programs for applications called as applets. Okay, applets that can be used through a browser. So the applets is used through the browser. So this allows a web page developer to create programs for the applications. An objective of Java developer is that it be machine platform. Okay, objective of the Java developers is that it be machine platform and the operating system independent. Okay, this is the machine platform and operating system independent. The special programming language, the example of this, some special programming language, scripting language. Okay, scripting language are there, command language are there, text language, processing languages are there. So scripting language is JavaScript and VBScript. Sorry. JavaScript and the VBScript. PHP, that is hypertext preprocessor. PHP is hypertext preprocessor. And ASP is active server pages. Okay, ASP is active server pages. Next scripting language is Perl and Python. Okay, Perl and Python is another example of the scripting language. Command language, the example of the command language, shell script, CSH, C shell, okay, bash. These all are the command language. Text processing languages, LaTeX, PostScript, these all are the example of the text processing languages. HTML, hypertext markup language, we already seen that. Okay, it is used in the on the internet and the World Wide Web. Web page developers puts brief codes called tags in the page to indicate how the page should be formatted. The next language is XML. XML is an extensible markup language and the language for defining other language. So programming languages comes to the mechanics of task. Learning to speak and use a programming languages is in a many way like learning to speak a human language. In these languages, you have to learn new vocabulary, syntax, and semantics. Okay, new vocabulary means new words. Syntax, sentence structure. Semantics, meaning. So and both kind of the language require considerable practice to make perfect. In English language, same likewise, the programming language both require considerable practice to make it perfect. So there are some MCQs are there. So these all are the MCQs. So these all are about the XML, HTML, CSS and the programming languages. I hope everyone understood it very well. Thank you. Thank you so much.